I think if the Democratic Party really is using replacement theory as a strategy to deal with their voting issues, upcoming voting issues, as far as getting more voters who are going to vote their way, I think it's going to fail. Obviously, the Democratic Party relies on black votes. Black people, when we vote, 90% of us vote for the Democratic Party when it comes to presidential elections. We're extremely loyal to the Democratic Party. But I don't think you can replicate that loyalty in other populations. More other populations are going to expect more from the Democratic Party. They're going to have more of a transactional relationship. They're going to respond if you actually produce something for them. I think this arrangement that the Democratic Party has with black people, where they're going to get support from black people no matter what, and they can ignore black people until it's time for elections, and they just say whatever the heck black people want to hear, and pretty much pretend like they care, and they still get the votes, that's not going to work on other groups. The cultures are just different. I mean, first, when you look at the Latino population, it's a lot of different populations. It's not just one population. You have Mexicans, you have Puerto Ricans, you have Cubans, you have Colombians, you have a lot of people from a lot of different regions, and the cultures aren't as liberal as the white liberals who run the Democratic Party. It's just not the same. Socially, they're not as liberal. They're not as progressive. Actually, kind of conservative in that sense. And economic policy is going to matter. They're going to look for economic results. You know, they're not just going to say, okay, blue no matter what. They're going to actually want results. So these two issues right up front is going to mean that if they don't deliver for this population, the Latinos, they're going to have some problems. You have this woke culture, this identity, pronoun type of culture that's being pushed, and that's not going to mesh well with a lot of the Latinos. A lot of the Latinos, especially in border states, they're going to want stability around the border. They're going to want stability. And you're going to have to respond with some results. And I think they're going to be more results oriented. So you're not going to have, 90% of Latinos voting for the Democratic Party year after year, no matter how bad things get. I don't think it's going to work out that way. The question is, will the black population make some changes as far as the alliance, the allegiance to the Democratic Party? That's a question I would have right there. And I guess we'll find out. But I don't think it's going to work out too well. I think with the first generation, a lot of these migrants, a lot of these people coming from South America. And by the way, it's not just people coming from Mexico and South America. We now have a lot of people coming from China. Did you know that? A lot of people come across the border from China. So, and maybe the first generation might be super loyal to the Democratic Party. But after that, these other populations, they're still going to value the same things that a lot of the whites and a lot of other people in this country value. So you still can't get away from certain fundamentals. You got to actually produce some real results if you want to keep voters voting for you. So I know there's a lot of emphasis on race and ethnicity and all this other stuff, especially in the Democratic Party. But at a certain point, we all have to go to the same grocery stores. Well, we all have to live in the same reality. And if this political party fails to produce results, then they're going to have some issues. So I don't think demographics are going to necessarily be destiny. The question is, will the Democratic Party wake up? Will it be enough sane people in the Democratic Party to wake them up and make the changes they need to stay, one, effective to actually help the communities that they promised to help? It's not good enough just to say, oh, Republicans are racist, Republicans are this and that. I mean, that's getting kind of tired. I mean, that can only work for so long, and it's starting to wear off. We're seeing signs of that. So, will they get their act together, or will we look at a situation where there may have to be another political party? Because this happened before. The whip party's been replaced. It's happened before. There's no guarantee that we're going to be stuck with these two parties. Maybe we might be stuck with another conservative party, other than the Republican Party, but we'll see. So what do you guys think? Do you think this replacement theory is even a real thing? And do you think it's going to hold? Do you think it's going to work out? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.